Till now we have studied all about racemose type of inflorescence. Now we study about second type of inflorescence, that is cymose. As said earlier, in this type of inflorescence, apical bud gets transformed into flower . Thus, in this type of inflorescence, we the development of axis becomes arrested. Cymose type of inflorescence is also further divided into subtypes. There are basically four types of cymose inflorescence. First is solitary cyme, second monocacial cyme, which can be either scorpoid or helicoid. Third is dicacial and fourth is polycacial. In solitary cyme, only one pedicellate flower is born terminally by the peduncle, as it can be seen from the figure. In uniparous, the main axis ends in a flower and grows continuously by a single lateral branch. In dicacial, the main axis ends in a flower after producing two daughter axes in a flower. Similarly, for polycacial, more than two axes are formed. First of all, let us begin with first type, that is cymose solitary. As said, in this type of inflorescence, only one pedicellate flower is formed terminally by the peduncle. In this type, a demarcation occurs in the stalk which differentiates between peduncle and pedicel. Example of such type of inflorescence is hippus. Thus, as it can be seen from the figure, it shows hibiscus flower exhibiting cymose solitary type of inflorescence. Second type of cymose inflorescence is uniparous or monocacial cyme. In this type of inflorescence, the main axis ends in a flower and the growth is continuous by a single lateral branch. As it can be seen from the figure that the monocacial cyme main axis ends in a flower and thereby growth continues as a single lateral branch. Now, simple monocacium is two types, scorpioid and helicoid. In scorpioid, as it can be seen from the figure, the apical bud that gives rise to a single branch. In scorpioid, these lateral branches are arranged alternately on right and left side. On the contrary, in helicoid, it is arranged on a single side. Thus, in helicoid type, the apical bud gives rise to a single lateral branch. Similarly, the apical bud of this lateral branch also gives rise to another single lateral branch. This growth occurs continuously in the same way, and thereby the order continues. If the new branches that are formed are sequentially arranged on a single side, then such a type of inflorescence is known as helicoid uniperiston. Which is also known as unilateral monocaceous type. Example of such type of inflorescence is Hemilia, which can be seen from the figure that here the branches arise on a single side, and therefore this type of inflorescence is known as helicoid monocaceous type. Now let us understand about another monocaceous thymus inflorescence, that is scorpioid. In this type, the new branches that are formed from the alternate apical buds get arranged in laterally alternate manner. That is alternately both on right and left side, and thus this type of inflorescence is known as scorpioid. Thus example of this type of inflorescence is heliotropium. As it can be seen from the figure, heliotropium is a flower exhibiting scorpio type of inflorescence, where the branches arise alternately on both right and left sides. Third type of inflorescence is dioecious or bipolar thymus inflorescence. This is a type of determinate inflorescence in which the main axis that ends in a flower develops two daughter axes. In a flower, and the process gradually goes on. Example of this type of inflorescence is jasmine. As it can be seen from the figure, it shows that in jasmine flowers, the floral bud before developing into flower gets divided into two daughter axes or two branches, and the process gradually continues. Thus, this type of inflorescence is known as dicaceous cyme. The fourth and final type of cymous inflorescence is multiparous or polycaceous cyme. In this type of inflorescence, the main axis whose apical bud gets transformed into flower develops many daughter axes which gets transformed into many flowers. Example for this type of inflorescence is calotropis. And the second example is red oleander. Thus, calotropis and red oleander, these two flowers exhibit polycaceous or multiparous type of cymous inflorescence.